A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th October, Monday. On the front page you have, Dhaka says it's reassured by Modi's briefing on NRC. So this is in the context of Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina's visit to India. So she and her delegation felt reassured after conversation with Prime Minister Modi. So the advisor to Sheikh Hasina says, these are things your ministers tell the people, but we don't go by what ministers say. PM Modi spoke to us directly and didn't remotely suggest any of what she said, any of what was said by Home Minister Mitch. So the final NRC will be completed only after all appeals are concluded in court. So Bangladesh has been reassured that NRC would not have fallouts with respect to Bangladesh. Because we have seen Home Minister has kept saying that all illegal Bangladeshi migrants would be sent out of the country. So there are concerns being raised. Because they are called Bangladeshi immigrants because they cannot prove their citizenship in the country. They don't have Indian citizenship proof. Then there should be Bangladeshi citizenship proof for Bangladesh to take them into. So that is also there. You can't just send them away. Some country has to take them. Then this is NC team meets Farooq Omar for first time since detention. So this is National Conference, the state political party of Jammu and Kashmir. The leader, the NC president, Farooq Abdullah and Omar Abdullah, they are, you can see, they were detained. And now the NC team members, National Conference party team members, met them for the first time since detention. There is another state political party in Jammu and Kashmir, which is PDP. That is People's Democratic Party. So leaders from Jammu are scheduled to meet even their party chief. Then below you have center steps help to cool off onion prices. So onion prices in Delhi have dropped below rupees 60 a kg mark in the retail market for the first time in 2 weeks now, because center is imposing measures like stock limits, banning exports. So they so this has cooled off the prices, but producers have called an agitation with one of the farmers groups threatening a strike if the ban is not lifted. So Maharashtra is also a major producer of onion, and there are assembly elections in Maharashtra in October now. So there is a concern with respect to onion prices now. Then this is Supreme Court bench to hear RA Forest case today. So Supreme Court on Monday will be hearing a plea against felling of 2,646 trees at the RA colony by Mumbai Metro Rail Corporation Limited to make way for a metro car shed. So Supreme Court has received letter from a delegation of law students against the axing of trees at RA Forest. So if you hear this PIL petition, a special bench will be constituted to hear the case. And this is the only Indian in the largest ever Arctic expedition. So this is Vishnu Nandan, a native of Kerala, who will be part of the study of Arctic climate. He'll be aboard the German research vessel Polar Stern, anchored on a large sheet of sea ice in the central Arctic. So you can see it will be at a pitch black polar winter that he would be staying for study. There are 300 scientists from across the world aboard this multidisciplinary drifting observatory for the study of Arctic climate. It's called Mosaic. So this expedition will have an Indian, you can see. On page 8, you have two trainee pilots killed as aircraft crashes in Telangana. So this was a crash which took place. The aircraft crashed into a cotton field in Telangana. And the victims here have been identified. It was a four-seater trainer aircraft belonging to Wings Aviation Private Limited, operating out of old airport in Hyderabad, Begumpet, Hyderabad. It crashed due to bad weather, it said. Then on page 9, you have police disrupt climate strike in Mumbai. So this is protesters who had gathered at Bandra Reclamation on Sunday morning, and they were demanding that government declare a climate emergency. The police dispersed them, and many protesters here claim that police warned them against bringing up the RA forest case. So that's why they brought up the idea of declaration of climate energy. That was the demand, though they actually wanted to protest for RA case. And as we saw on the front page, Supreme Court is going to begin hearing on the RA forest case. Then this is RERA Act applicable to plots sold under industrial project. So this is Tamil Nadu Real Estate Appellate Tribunal, which has upheld a ruling by the Tamil Nadu Real Estate Regulatory Authority that projects such as SEZ and estates involving sale of industrial plots to investors come under the purview of RERA. So this verdict is significant. So it's not just for residential but also industrial projects, SEZs. On the editorial page, you have the first editorial, sedition annoyance. So this is regarding the larger judiciary, how it should not act reflexively on frivolous politically motivated complaints. So case of sedition being registered against 49 prominent citizens by at a police station in Bihar by for writing an open letter to the Prime Minister has resulted in outrage. So how is it sedition? That's annoying, is what the editorial speaks of. And second is best friends forever. So this is regarding India-Bangladesh relations. So there are areas of concern too between the two. So those are discussed here. Your Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina of Bangladesh was on a visit to India. So trade relations need to improve, as we have seen. Then there are water sharing related concerns too. Then LPG supply across the border, that is also being considered. There are three projects, you know, which have been inaugurated presently. One of them is for availability of LPG to India. Then you can see the long pending upgrading of Ganga Padma barrage project. The draft framework for interim sharing of agreements for 6 rivers and the draft framework for interim sharing of agreement for Feni River are all pending. Then another concern which Bangladesh has is with respect to NRC exercise in Assam and its fallout for Bangladesh. So though Home Minister Amit Shah has given various statements, you know, calling them non-citizens as termites. So, and Bangladeshi, illegal Bangladeshi immigrants. So, Bangladesh has concerns, but then they have been cooled by the statement given by Prime Minister, assurance given by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The lead article here is a bill that undercuts key constitutional values. So, this is regarding the Citizenship Amendment Bill, which tries to give citizenship to illegal migrants of minority religion from Muslim majority countries, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and Afghanistan. So minorities from there, like Hindus, Sikhs, Christians, Parsis, Jains, would be given citizenship in India, though they are illegal migrants presently. So it says there is ample evidence that the protection of minorities is not the genuine objective of Citizenship Amendment. So the article on that. And this is a road to economic revival runs through agriculture. So we are seeing currently a slowdown in growth. So this article says that this is an ideal time to implement doable agricultural reforms. So this is very important because a huge part of our economy is also rural. So that needs to be revived as well. And that can bring in, make an inroad to even overall revival of the economy. Then on OPET page, you have this article, criticism is not sedition. So the threat of sedition actually leads to unauthorized self-censorship and has a chilling effect on free speech. So this is Lokmanya Tilak, who was also charged for sedition. So that sedition basically is in writing or in speaking. It's only in words, not in action. If you are undertaking any action against the government, any act against the government, that would be a criminal offense. But sedition is a law, a British era law, which is for anything said or written against the government. So it's considered against the government, but if it's against a policy of the government, it's criticism, it's not necessarily sedition. So there have been many recommendations to remove the sedition clause from Indian law, but it has not been done and it is being used frequently too. Sedition provisions. On page 13, you have Center in the Dark on Detention Curbs. So this was an RTI query on which Home Ministry has replied that on detentions and curbs in Jammu and Kashmir, it has no information. It has directed the applicant to Jammu and Kashmir administration that you go and put an RTI in Jammu and Kashmir administration. But we have seen information is not flowing out of Jammu and Kashmir and an RTI being put in Jammu and Kashmir is not possible. So this is how the response has been averted. So Home Ministry says it has no information on what's going on. It's in the dark. Then this is police block JKLF's protest march from POK to LOC. So this is a protest march which has started from Pakistan occupied Kashmir and has reached up to LOC. It is 8 kilometers from the frontier. So agitators here are staging a sit-in against the lockdown on the Indian side. And here you have in China, and here you have US team visits POK to study ground situation. So US congressional delegation actually gave its report on German Kashmir also, and and now it has visited Pakistan occupied Kashmir side too, and it has studied the ground situation and has shared rights concerns as it had for Indian side of German Kashmir too in present scenario. And here you have in China, Imran to take up Gen K issue. So Prime Minister of Pakistan Imran Khan will be visiting China. So we'll get further news about it too. So, next steps for collaboration between the two countries will be discussed on Afghanistan and also on China-Pakistan economic corridor. So these issues are on agenda. And this is India starts sharing maritime data. So this is regarding Information Fusion Center, Indian Ocean Region, IFC IOR. So this center was set up in 2018 and has started functioning as an information sharing hub of maritime data. So this is the Navy's, this is belonging to Indian Navy and it is in Gurugram. So it's a single point center linking all coastal radar chain networks across the 7,000 along the 7,500 kilometer Indian coastline and in some neighboring countries too. So it tracks and monitors shipping vessels in real time round the clock. So maritime data would also be shared by India. Then there's no important news on the international page. It's same continuation of the news on Trump's impeachment, on his call to Ukrainian president, which we have already discussed twice or thrice. Then this is regarding Hong Kong protests, which continue. And again, Brexit issue, the negotiations continue. So there's no final deal yet. So that is it. Then on business page on Mondays, you don't have business coverage. You can see. So after foreign coverage, you have education plus added. Plus business also has individual business, what you should do about insurance and all that. So it's individual guidelines given. And then you have the sports news. So that is it. The last page also has sports news. So that is it. These were the important headlines. Thank you.